New at 10, the Lawrence County Board of Education voted to shut down R.A. Hubbard High School. Way 31's Nicole Zedek joins us live from outside the Lawrence County Board of Education meeting. Nicole, how was the community turnout tonight?
Dan, people actually started lining up outside here around 5 o'clock, an hour before the meeting even started. And once inside, I'd say about 100 people packed into that room to voice their concern over the closure of R.A. Hubbard High School. Passionate community members voicing their concern over the closure of R.A. Hubbard High School minutes before the school board comes to a vote.
I'm asking you, please do not close R.A. Hubbard.
A dozen people spoke to the board, all pushing for R.A. Hubbard to remain open. Many stating students are getting a better education than they would at the two transfer schools, Haddon and East Lawrence High.
Think about this decision, because this decision is going to hurt our children.
But in the end, it wasn't enough to sway the board.
I have it 4-1 for the closure of R.A. Hubbard. And now it goes to court.
The federal court has final say in the motion since R.A. Hubbard is under a desegregation order. However, by distributing the students from the predominantly black school, an attorney for the school board says the school will follow the desegregation order by balancing out the demographics throughout the district.
Ultimately, we're looking at the very best for students. We want to provide them the greatest opportunity possible.
The school board has been discussing closing R.A. Hubbard since 2019, since it is the smallest high school in the district and enrollment keeps dropping year after year. The superintendent says it's just too expensive to keep open, and they think they can provide more resources to the students if they combine the schools. Reporting live in Lawrence County, Nicole Zedek, Way 31 News.
Thanks, Nicole. The school superintendent says if the court rules in favor of closing R.A. Hubbard, the school system could save between $500,000 to $1 million in the first year.